Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, what up? So today I'm gonna be showing you guys what is in my makeup bags currently. I kind of wanted to do like a makeup bag refresh for the new year. These are products that I wanted to throw in here because I wanted to use them. I wanted to get to know them, focus on them, whatever the case may be. I did one of these what's in my makeup bag videos a few months ago actually, so woo girl, it's been time to refresh that makeup bag for the longest. Plus I got some new makeup bags in. I don't think I've shown you guys these. I got them in a while ago, but I don't know if I showed you guys these makeup bags. But yeah, I got them off of Amazon. I think I did actually do a video. I did like a pack with me video a while ago showing you guys these bags. But if you didn't see that video, these are the bags right here. So this one is kind of like a toiletry bag, and I just dump my eyeshadow palettes and setting sprays in here. So this is obviously a luxury checkered brand from off of Amazon, Louis Vuitton dupe, if you will. And then I also have like the carrying case as well, which it is so cute, you guys. When you unzip it, it has the red interior on the inside that makes it look super luxurious. This would be a great last minute gift to get somebody if you have Amazon Prime. Girl, it might even arrive before Christmas. This would be a really, really nice last minute gift to get a makeup lover in your family. Hint, hint. So yeah, this is really nice, and as you guys can see, it's one of those makeup bags that everybody and their mom has had since last year that has the little compartments, and you can interchange them. You can pull them out, like take them all out if you want to, or you can put more in to just go ahead and divide your makeup up. And then it has this Velcro flap right here where you can keep brushes, eyeliners, lip liners, lip products, whatever you want. And then it has this zipper compartment right here. So these makeup bags are really, really nice. They're really, really inexpensive. They come in a bunch of different designs. You guys know I used to have the marble print one, but girl, this one is cuter. I just wanted to have this one. So yeah, like I said, I'm about to show you guys what's in my makeup bag currently. So if you want to see that, then just keep on watching. Okay, so I'm gonna save the palettes and stuff for last, because y'all know like eyeshadow is like one of my favorite parts of makeup. So we're gonna start with the big girl right here. We're gonna start with her. So I'm gonna start with my eye stuff first that's in here. So you guys know I have to have this in my makeup bag. This is my Smashbox Photo Finish Hydrating Under Eye Primer. I do my makeup with this every single time. I use this every single time that I do my makeup. I'm holding it up to the light right now and I'm like running low, so I need to order another one from Ulta, but I have to have that every single time I do my makeup. I have one liquid eyeliner in here because, girl, that's all I need. This is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Black Liquid Liner. I love this. It's very nice and easy to create a line or a wing or whatever you want. Very skinny, not flimsy at all. Very black matte eyeliner. Love her. I have one pencil eyeliner. I have this. Actually, I have two pencil eyeliners. I'm tripping. I have the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide On Pencil in Perversion, which is just the blackest black eyeliner ever. And then, of course, I have my nude. This is the ColourPop Honey Dude Nude Eyeliner. That's like the only one that I use because it's so good. For my eyebrow product, which I just repurchased a new one from Ulta because your girl is on a nub. Can y'all see that? I had to order pick up order from Ulta because this one is a nub. But this is the Maybelline Total Temptation Brow Definer in 315 Deep Brown. Absolutely love that. It's about to go in my empties that I need to film for you guys. But yeah, I'm gonna throw that in there. And then I have my Benefit Precisely My Brow Ultra Fine Brow Defining Pencil in the shade number 5. Another one that I can't live without. I'm happy I'm not running out of that one. And then I have one mascara. This is the Maybelline Lash Sensational Luscious Full Fan Effect Mascara. This has been like my favorite mascara ever since I got it. It does wonders for my eyelashes. So yeah, all of those things are in the makeup bag for like eye stuff. Then I'm gonna move on to like eyeshadow type products. So I have my Urban Decay eyeshadow primer potion in Eden in here. I use that to do my eyeshadow today. This is a spectacular base if you're a brown skin girl, because it has more of like that yellowy base to it, and it's really, really light, so it's really gonna make your eyeshadows pop. I'm obsessed with it. Got my little sharpener in here just for convenience. This is the Ulta Beauty sharpener, and it has two sizes in there, so very convenient to have that. I have some glitters in here because why not? It's the holidays. I have actually been wearing a lot of glitter. So these are the Urban Decay Heavy Metal Glitter Eyeliners, and I got these in a set a couple of years ago, and they still work perfectly fine. So I have Midnight Cowboy, which is more of that like yellow gold type of shade. I have Volume, which is more of a pink, has a little bit of shift to it, like some copper and some gold in there. It's really pretty. And then I have Starfire, which is my personal favorite because it's like that bronzy gold type of glitter. It's perfection. I love it. So I threw these in here because festivities, holiday parties, filming YouTube videos, whatever, I want to have some glitter on hand. And then I have some eye products that are a little bit glittery. So I have a Dose of Colors Block Party eyeshadow in Encore in here. This used to be my absolute favorite type of eyeshadow back when I was living in Georgia, and I just rediscovered these, so I pulled out one to start back using them. I love Encore. As you guys can see, it's like that really reddish brown with a crap ton of glitter running through it. It is super pretty on the lid, like gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. And then I threw a ColourPop Super Shock eyeshadow in here in the color Twitter Pated, which is really pretty. I don't know, I've been really into this like pinky gold shifting type of shade. You guys can see I've been using it. It's really pretty and I really like it. So I threw that in here. And then I also threw in a pair of lashes. These are kind of like, not really everyday lashes, but they're a little less dramatic, especially like the ones that I have on now. Girl, these are dramatic, but these are a little bit less dramatic just to have in here. So yeah, that's what I got in here for my eye products. Let me put all of this back in. Okay, so moving on to the face. So I have two face primers in here. I have the Morphe foundation primer in Equalizer. They have two of these type of base primers from Morphe. This one is the more silicone based one, which I felt would work better for my skin. And then I have the e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer. You guys know this is like everyone's favorite. I had to throw this in here because it really has been doing wonders for my makeup lately. I actually am wearing it today, and my face is flawless, if I do say so myself. So yeah, I just wanted to keep her in here to play around with her. For foundations, I have three that I want to play around with. So of course, my L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Foundation. Girl, I've done a whole lot of talking about this foundation in a couple videos, so she's in here. She's a favorite. And then I also threw in my Urban Decay Stay Naked foundation. Again, she's still a favorite, still love her, so I wanted to put her in here. And then one that I haven't talked about in a minute, this is my Il Makiage Woke Up Like This Flawless Base Foundation. I have the shade 195 in this, and I just wanted to play around with her a lot more because I haven't shown her any love since like earlier this year, like the beginning of this year. So definitely wanted to throw her in here to play around with her. For concealer, I have four different concealers here, but one of them is for cream contouring, which is my e.l.f. 16 Hour Camo Concealer in Rich Cocoa. Used her today. I love this to cream contour. Then I threw in my Stay Naked Correcting Concealer to go with the foundation, and this one is in the shade 60 NN. Really nice, bright highlighting shade for me, and I do like this concealer. It's one of those concealers that it stays under my eyes and it doesn't crease or anything like that. So that one is really, really nice. A little drying, but still nice. Of course, a classic Tarte Shape Tape. I still and will probably always love this concealer. I just can never go wrong with it. It works with all foundations, all setting powders. It always looks good. It doesn't crease, which is like mind-blowing. Even without baking this concealer, it does not crease. So, and that is unheard of with these little fine lines I have under my eyes. But girl, that's one of them. And then the L'Oreal Infallible Full Wear Concealer. I threw this bad boy in here because for one, she needs to be used up. She getting kind of up there in age. She needs to be used up, and it's a really good concealer, and I do like the color of her. Only one setting powder, under eye setting powder. This is the ColourPop No Filter setting powder in banana. I need to get a couple of loose setting powders out of my collection because I have a crap ton and I never focus on just one. I'm always like using different ones. So I threw that in here to kind of girl focus on that one, like use her. And then I have one face powder in here. This is my Urban Decay Stay Naked The Fix pressed face setting powder. But girl, she broke. I don't even know how she broke, when she broke, what happened, but as you guys can see, she is shattered to pieces. So I put this in here because I do want to focus on this. I do like this powder, and since it's broke, might as well use it, right? So we gonna take extra special care of her, but she is in here. Then I have three bronzers. So I have my Nabla Skin Bronzing Sun-Kissed Effects Bronzing Powder in the shade Profile. I told you guys in, I think it was a first impressions, I don't really remember, that I don't really like this bronzer just because I feel like I have to do too much to get it to show up on my skin. And not because of the color, because the color is actually dark enough to show up on my skin. It's just the formula of the product. I have to use a specific type of brush, and then I have to make sure that it's not patchy. I kind of have to stipple it on my skin instead of actually swiping it like I would do with a regular powder bronzer. This one is kind of baked, I believe, and like baked formulas are not always the best. You kind of have to really blend and work and make them look nice on the skin. But I did want to play around with it a little bit more because I did spend a pretty penny on her. So I wanted to play around with her. I wanted to throw in my e.l.f. Constantly Bronze bronzer. This was like one of my favorite bronzers during the winter time last year. It looks a little bit light on camera, but I promise you this bronzer works for my skin at warming it up. It's really pretty, really nice. I really like it. Want to show her some love. And then last, I have the bronzer that I've been using practically every day that I've done my makeup for the last couple of weeks. This is the Milani Silky Matte Bronzing Powder in Sun Drenched. She looks like that. Nice brown bronzer shade. I am wearing her today, like I said, on top of that e.l.f. cream contour, and I think my bronzer looks beautiful today, if I do say so myself. So yeah, these are all of the products that I have in here for my face. So let me go ahead and throw these back in here. All right, and then also for my face, I have a blush. This is the e.l.f. Always Spicy Blush. If you've not tried any of e.l.f. blushes, girl, you sleep, you're missing out. You don't know what you're missing out on because their blushes are super nice, super pigmented, stay on the face all day. They have a huge array of shades. Anybody can find a color that they like. They're really nice and they're gonna last you a long time because this is a pretty nice size blush. So I fucks with it. And then I have another blush in here. This is the Morphe Blush Trio, and this is in the shade Pop of Rose. I put this in here because during the winter time, we typically wear more rosy tone blushes, or maybe you don't. Maybe that's just me, but I do. I'm wearing it today. I mix this color right here and this color. Is it showing up or my light is too bright? There we go. I mix this shade and this shade together to get this nice rosy blush that you guys see on my cheeks right now. I really love these Morphe blush trios. I talked about them in my 2020 yearly favorites. If you guys didn't watch that video, go and check it out. I will leave it in the cards somewhere. And then this is the Shayla X ColourPop Loose Highlighter in Boomin. Guys, how long ago did this collection come out? I still have this highlighter, have not shown it a whole lot of love, so want to go ahead and put that in there. I am wearing her today. She's super pretty, super beaming, really nice. I love loose highlighters. I've been loving them for the last like few months now. It's really pretty, so I needed to go ahead and throw that in there. And now we can move on to lip products. By the way, inside of the little zipper compartment, I just have my Amreezy mirror for easy access. It fits nice and perfectly into that little zipper pocket. But inside of the Velcro, here are my actual lip products. I have two lip liners. I have my Morphe Trendsetter lip pencil. This is a really dark espresso brown type of lip liner. I am wearing it on the outskirts of my lips today to line them. Love this lip liner, always will. And then I added in my Juvia's Place Luxe liner in the shade Cola. This one is a little bit lighter, not as dark as the Morphe one, but it's a really nice brown to go ahead and define my lips really, really nicely. So I have that in there. I also have my ColourPop So Juicy Plumping Gloss in Princess Cut. It's just a clear gloss. I'm about to pull out all of these clear glosses. Not clear glosses. I'm about to pull out all of these So Juicy glosses from my collection into my Shop My Stash. I will be filming the Shop My Stash coming up soon, you guys. So don't worry, it's coming. But yeah, I'm about to pull out all of my ColourPop So Juicy glosses and put them in my Shop My Stash, because those are lip products that I need to focus on coming into the new year. So yeah, I'll be throwing all of those in. I have my Too Faced Lip Injection Maximum Plump Extra Strength Instant and Long-Term Lip Plumper. You guys know I like to use this before I even start my makeup. I feel like it does a good job at plumping up these already beautiful lips. Then I have my Juvia's Place lipstick in the shade Lady. I told you guys in my yearly favorites that I fell in love with this lipstick. It is perfection. Love the color. Really nice brown toned nude. Very pretty. I love it. And it goes perfectly with that liner. Another lipstick I have in here. This is a red. This is from the Pure X Barbie Round 2 collection. It's called Endless Possibilities, I believe. But this is their lipstick in the shade CEO. First of all, you guys, how neat is that? The whole collection, the packaging was bomb, but this is the lipstick that I put in here. It's a nice red because it's the holidays. It's such a gorgeous red. I love this red. Very pretty. I love that whole Barbie collection. I did not do a video on it, which sucks, but love that whole collection. Another liquid lipstick I have in here is this Mini Dose of Colors Heartbreaker liquid lipstick. I still love this. It is almost finished, but I wanted to throw it in here because not only is it almost finished, but I actually really like it. And then the last gloss I have in here, this is the Fenty Beauty Cake Shake lip gloss from her mini holiday collection. Absolutely love this color gloss. It goes on top of nudes. Really, really pretty. So wanted to throw her in here. So that is everything that's actually in this part of my makeup bag. So I'm gonna move on to this part, which, like I said, this contains all of my eyeshadow palettes. So these are the eyeshadow palettes that I've been using lately, wanting to use lately, whatever the case may be. I'll probably switch these out faster than I'll switch the makeup from out of this part of my makeup bag, but y'all know how that goes. So I do have my NYX Bare With Me Prime Set and Refresh spray in here. This is the new bottle of it. I do have this in here because I can't do my makeup without spraying my face with that first. I haven't done my makeup without spraying that first. It's a habit that I can't stop. And then my actual makeup setting spray that I use when my makeup is all done, this is the Maybelline Lasting Fix Up to 16 Hour Wear Matte Finish Setting Spray. This is one of the best setting sprays out there right now at the drugstore. Go and get you some. Run to Ulta, Walmart, Walgreens, wherever, and just get you some, okay? My trusty Amreezy palette. Love her. I've been using her. I can't get over this palette. Like I told you guys, this, she created me when she created this palette, because this is me in a palette. Literally, I love the colors, love the shades, love the glitters, love everything about it. I wanted to put it in here. The next palette I have, this is the Too Faced Salted Caramel Little Mini 10 Eyeshadow Palette. I really, really enjoy this palette, you guys. This is the palette that I'm wearing on my eyes today. It is so cute. I was wearing it on my eyes in I don't remember what video it was, but child, if y'all check the description, y'all know I always leave my makeup details in the description of all of my videos, but I was wearing it in one of my other videos and I focused mainly on these pinky shades right here. Today I went for the orangey bronze shades and it is so pretty. The formula is so pretty. I love these little mini 10 eyeshadow palettes from Too Faced, so I threw that in there just to use it whenever. I threw in my ColourPop Good as Gold eyeshadow palette. This was the palette that I used last year for my New Year's makeup look, and I came up with the most beautiful look using this palette. She is really reflective, but she is perfection with all of these different tones of gold. It is so pretty. This palette is the ultimate, like, eyeshadow palette formula, because y'all, you have your mattes, you have your shimmers, you have foils, you have metallics, you have glitters, pressed glitters, you have mattes with glitters. Like, this palette literally contains everything in it, and like I said, it's all in different shades of gold. You can't go wrong with this. This is a perfect festive palette. I don't know if this is still on the ColourPop website, but if it is, you absolutely need to have it in your collection if you're a fan of gold. If you're not a fan of gold, then pass on it, but if you're a fan of gold, you absolutely need this. The colors are beautiful. I will go ahead and link the video I did last year with this palette, and I'm sure you will love that video. That makeup look was bomb. Desi X Katie Francation palette. Like, all of these palettes are like the ultimate glam holiday festive palettes to create a really pretty holiday look. I have this in here because, I mean, they don't even sell this palette anymore, which is such a shame because it was on the market for so freaking long and they got rid of it now, but I'm gonna cherish it until the end of time, okay? I also have in here this Too Faced Palm Springs Dreams eyeshadow palette. I really like this one. It's really pretty. It has some really nice colors in it. Really nice formula. The mattes are really nice. The shimmers are really pigmented. Right up my alley too, because we got some pinks. We got a bronze. We got some orangey tones. It's really pretty. So I really like it. Kind of reminds me of the Amreezy palette, but I have it in there. Whatever. Okay, and then I also have this Lorac Pro palette. This is the Soleil Pro palette. So this is actually new. I bought this when it first came out on the Ulta website. And this is a really pretty, just neutral, everyday go-to type of eyeshadow palette. This is all shimmers. These are all mattes. And they sell refills to this palette because you can pop it open on the back and you can rearrange the shades, or you can refill the shades that you hit pan on. And they have the refills and this palette and everything on Ulta. They also came out with some different variations of this palette. Like, one is more of a like smoky palette, and then they have another one. Just go check it out on the Ulta website. I really do like this palette, really do like the formula. You guys can see that I've actually been using this one because the colors in here are actually really, really pretty. I really like it. And then the very last palette I have in here is the Artist Couture Supreme Nudes eyeshadow palette. I know all of these are basically the same type of palette, but girl, don't judge me, okay? When you have a huge collection like me, you gotta get use out of everything. So it doesn't matter if the palettes look the same, you gotta use them, okay? But this is a really gorgeous, beautiful, like it says, nude eyeshadow palette. Very, very gorgeous, easy, everyday, effortless, soft, glam, whatever you want to do with type of palette. But it's really pretty. I really enjoy the formula, and I just like this palette overall. It's very sleek, very high-end feeling, like luxurious type makeup feeling. I love it. Absolutely love it. So that is it, you guys. That is everything that was in here. And as you guys can see, this also has like the kind of red inside. But yeah, that is everything that I had in here. This bag holds so much stuff. You can stuff it with makeup, okay? But that's everything that I wanted to show you guys that's currently in my makeup bag. I will be changing my makeup bag out periodically, and I'll film it for you guys so you can just, you know, be nosy and see what's in my makeup bag. If you enjoyed this video, you already know, go ahead and give it a big thumbs up. Leave me a comment down below letting me know what key products you gotta have in your makeup bag. If you film one of these videos, drop it down in the comments below. If you are new, definitely go ahead and hit the subscribe button as well as the bell notification so that you can be notified every single time that I upload a video. And I'll see you guys in my next one. Peace.